And we talked about one of the new features we have introduced to Capcom Live in the last year. And it is the support for using this as a
the position of each
of a each row entry starting from the top on the next on the next request for a change in the header data. There has been a further data size optimization, and instead of sending only row entries data when the row 8 now we send only row entries data when the row 8 change of tools. So instead of sending a big list, even if we have a row of the same 8, we send a smaller list that every entry has a different size from the previous one, and the one between the first and the successive entries have all the same size of the first entry. And this is why we didn't do it immediately, but it has required a bit for the work on the client side. And at the beginning, the main goal was to not be dependent from the position of the document, and that was already successfully obtained by sending only the visible part of the header. So, on the getting the loop controls working also online, we needed to perform some changes on the code side. The actualized state changed some methods which are devoted to show or hide the group of control are invoked, and these methods would belong to SC outline dot function dot counter class. And each of these methods invoke on lock show hide outline in the lock case, which take care of performing cache position validation, because commonly if we have cached the position of the last row when a collapse on proof, the registration is no more valid. Moreover, we need also to invalidate in the header, because obviously they are changed, and we need also to notify the server day and marker data changing that in turn triggering the updating of the cursor overlay in the client and of the mark selection in the client. That obviously is needed because when you collapse or show a loop of row, the selection can in the same way collapsing or enlarging. Another feature we have introduced is that we have rendered both headers and both outline on the client using Canvas 3D. Before, header entry was rendered using the div HTML element. Here, each row header entry, there was some piece of HTML code where you can see where this is the header entry size, and also we attached some information such as the index of the row. Well, that can be thinking of the solution for row, since it is the same of the although one of the fact that obviously for Paul it's not the same because it wanted the bullet in Electra. We performed this change, this switch from the view to canvas, essentially because it makes it a lot easier to implement the group quantum solution interface. So, anyway, we did that to handling to implement the mouse event endings, because earlier event endings was attached to the event, and we needed to keep track of the current index that the mouse is over, because it is used when a row is inserted among the show or show or hide, because we needed to send a message to the core in order to perform the task, and this message needed to have the current index set as a parameter. So we need to implement on mouse over for the canvas element that internally track on which element in the mouse is over, and in that case retrieving the current index as we did earlier. Moreover, we needed also to keep track still in this method when the cursor is in the small area between two row entries, because in that case the cursor appearance needed to be changed, and we need to enable this object equipment for that entry that is usually used for selecting the full row.
The top of the document, and also the side.
and is provided definitely from the function you see below. So when index inside the depth level, and the start position from the start of the document, and the end position, the start position of the end of the group entry control, and the end position of the group entry control that is of the type of the control. And moreover, each state that is if it should be shown or if it should be. The method which receives this data is still a few rows, which see that there are groups, and then resides the canvas object, where both the group path line and the row header is. And in case we have groups and parts of the group data, and then draw any group entry by using still canvas GD primitives. Another further feature is that the header column that usually is used, the only element it receives is a click for selecting the full. The whole spreadsheet, and it has its own canvas element and its own event element for any cases where we select just a moment. Now the corner, the other corner, the other corner has also the level controls to show or hide the group entry in that level, and obviously it was interested to implement the mouse in the mouse. Over event the ending of which group level we were over. Maybe someone would think that there could be some control library for JavaScript that we could use it instead of implementing these mouse event ending in a general way, but in the end, the work was small and it would have added a further events. And moreover, of course, we have attached a new entry for grouping and ungrouping. Group of rows or column as we had in the desktop case. So I thank you for listening, and if there are any questions.